Today I want to talk about Tylan Wallace and what I hope hasn't happened. All that's coming up after the bumper.
Don't be cornering me. Hold up. Time. You gotta help me with that corner sh**.
What's up, kinfolk? It's RJ Young. I am not on a step mill. Consider hitting the like and subscribe button because I upload a video every single day. It's always OU-related, college football-related, sports-related. We have a good time. And today, I want to talk about Tylan Wallace and what we hope has not happened. Wallace suffered a non-contact injury that led to him needing an MRI and being examined again on Friday for his knee. Now, there is no news that has been reported except what the Oklahoman has got through sources, which is to say the fear is the non-contact injury will not only limit him against Oklahoma or against TCU when Oklahoma State plays Texas Christian, but it could be an ACL tear. We hope that's not the case. I sincerely want to see Tylan Wallace play football because he's putting together a remarkable season, especially when you consider what he's had to work with. He's got 53 catches for over 900 yards. He is fifth among FBS receivers in receiving this year, averaging 17.0 yards per catch. And my goodness, has he ever just been playing outstanding football the last couple of years? I thought he got robbed of the Biletnikoff Award last year after putting up 1,491 yards receiving and catching 86 passes from Taylor Cornelius. Wallace nearly single-handedly willed Oklahoma State to a win against Oklahoma in Norman. We're talking about a guy that, if he does not get this throw short-armed by Taylor Cornelius, catches the winning pass in the end zone to beat an Oklahoma team that ended up playing in the college football playoff and winning the Big 12 championship. And this year, Oklahoma State, not in a good way, as Texas Christian seems to be figuring it out. Max Duggan is actually playing better football right now than Spencer Sanders has been playing, which is really an indictment of what's been going on at Oklahoma State. But when you look at the three-headed monster that we expected to be so much fun, Tylan Wallace and Chuba Hubbard are holding up their end. Spencer Sanders needed to hold up his just a little bit better because Spencer Sanders essentially had three reads. Hand the ball to Chuba Hubbard, pull the ball down, run himself, or throw the ball to number two. And as much as I would like to see Dylan Stoner get more opportunities to make catches, and I think that Jordan McRae could be an outstanding target, particularly in the red zone, and Jelani Woods could be outstanding at tight end, been held back by the quarterback play. And that sucks for Chuba Hubbard. It sucks for Tylan Wallace because this is a year in which Tylan was probably going to come out anyway, but I really selfishly want to see him play more games at Oklahoma State and don't want to think about this perhaps being his last having been played a week ago. However, I understand you got to do what you got to do, and I believe that he's going to be one of the first wide receivers off the board in a year where it's just loaded with receivers. Justin Jefferson's awesome. Jamar Chase is awesome. CeeDee Lamb, also awesome with 56 catches. We expect him to be a first-round pick. Jerry Jeudy has been awesome. Michael Pittman Jr. at USC has been awesome. Even Isaiah Hodgins at Oregon State has been awesome. Just a loaded group of wide receivers playing football in 2019 right now at the college level. But what does this mean for Oklahoma State? Well, it means the difference between your season actually ending with perhaps just the three losses and us looking at you and going, I don't know what you're going to be able to do without Wallace because I don't actually have to respect you throwing the ball anymore if I am a defense, to say nothing if I would have just double covered Tylan Wallace anyway, and now I get to use that eighth man and bring him down in the box and try to devote all of my resources to stopping Chuba Hubbard if I'm not doing that already, because Chuba has been the best tailback in football this year. I don't know if that's good enough to win them a Heisman Trophy, but he's been outstanding. And also, you want Spencer Sanders to just not turn the ball over, man. If he doesn't throw it to the other team and put it on the ground, Oklahoma State might be looking at a couple of games that they lost that they probably should have won. And I get that you don't want to throw this all at Spencer Sanders' feet and you want to give him an opportunity in his first year as a starter to figure it out, but he came in with lots of hype coming out of Denton Ryan, where he threw for all the yards, ran for all the yards, and was Mr. Texas Football. I thought that he was going to be on the level of every great Big 12 quarterback we've come to know, not necessarily just the Heisman winners like Kyler or Baker, but also guys like Will Greer. And even to a degree, Sam Ellinger, who's got some weird symmetry with Tylan Wallace. They were tied in recruiting coming out of the state of Texas when we're talking about rankings. Both of them have had outstanding careers. And in this, Tylan Wallace's redshirt sophomore season, you had to think that if he finished with anything like the production that he had last year, that he was going to come out. Now, not only do I wonder if he's going to come out, if he gets a first-round grade, I think he's coming. But he might also just decide that he wants to just tell everybody that this is what he's going to do instead of just thinking it through the rest of the season, because I know that Oklahoma State fans selfishly would like to see him come back, especially with Spencer Sanders having a year underneath his belt and with Chuba Hubbard also coming back after this season to where, yeah, man, Oklahoma State could be a problem in a league that's going to be full of problems next year. The Big 12 has demonstrated through the middle and at the bottom, it's actually really stout. The worst team in the Big 12, West Virginia, by my math, played the undefeated team in the Big 12 to a three-point game in a game where Baylor was supposed to win by 18 points. And West Virginia showed up with their defense and they showed up with their special teams play. If they got anything like offensive production, they might have beat Baylor in McLean. And all of these kids are coming back next year. I mean, Sam Ellinger probably doesn't get a first-round grade, so you got to believe that he's coming back. So all the quarterbacks are going to get that much better. Oklahoma's going to be breaking in a brand-new quarterback that most people expect to be Spencer Rattler, but either way, it's going to be a guy that hasn't started any games at this level, provided Lincoln Riley doesn't do that thing where he goes in the transfer portal, and that's another segment altogether. But I think for now, I really want Tylan Wallace to be good. Good, healthy. I want him to be okay. If he has to miss the TCU game, fine. If it's a sprain, great. If it's even like a grade 3, also great, because that means that he doesn't actually have to go through the process of having surgery and or going through extensive rehab following such an injury. But I would expect him to be out for the Texas Christian game, in a game that Oklahoma State quite literally has to win to keep itself alive. And you have to think going into that game, Oklahoma State expected to beat Texas Christian, especially with a true freshman quarterback in Max Duggan, even as that defense continues to be really, really stout. All right, that's it for me. Deuces.